In this video, I'll be showing you how to install this web-based touch interface on an ESP32. This lets you remotely control a motor-driven vehicle from almost any device. Just a bit of an overview of how this software solution works. We have our mobile device or a web browser. To start off with, we'll navigate to the IP address of the ESP32, which fetches a response from its web server. It serves back a page that has JavaScript on it that displays widgets and allows you to provide input. That input is fed back through this WebSocket, which then controls either a step motor controller or DC motor controllers that drive each of the motors. Okay, to get started, I'll be using Platform.io instead of Arduino IDE to do my development. I'll be doing this because it's really easy to install. There's no downloading and installing the Espressive SDK. It's all done for you. So open up Visual Studio Code. If you go to the extensions and search for Platform.io, you'll find the Platform.io IDE, which you can install. Once it's installed, you'll have this taskbar down in your tray where you can go to the Platform.io home, or this opens every time you open Visual Studio Code now. From here, you can see different boards and platforms. I have the Espressive 32 platform installed, and here I should be able to see my ESP32 plugged in, sitting on COM3. You can download my example project from GitHub. So the link is in the description. It's separated into a few different sections. There's the main.cpp, which is the main program. There's some instructions right at the top. Please read through this. There is one change to a source file that we need to do. We also need to set up your Wi-Fi SSID and password. If you're using stepper motors, the steps per revolutions, and all the pins that you're controlling your motors from. The rest is separated into pages. These are the HTML, CSS, and JavaScript pages that the ESP32 web server serves. So in here we can see we've got minified strings of each page. And I serve the jQuery and Interact JavaScript files from the ESP32. So you shouldn't need an internet connection to be able to use the interface. There's also two libraries, one for DC motor control and one for stepper motor controls using timers. This is a copy of the Arduino stepper motor interface that's been stripped down to only four-wire bipolar stepper motors, and it's been highly modified to use ESP32 timers instead of delay loops. Once everything's set up, you can build, upload, and then open the serial monitor. Once you've uploaded, you can open the serial monitor and grab the IP address that your ESP32 has obtained. Once we have the IP address, we can go to its web page. Here I'm using a web browser, but you can use any browser from a mobile device. To start off with, hit the spanner and brings up this configuration options where you can go into configuration. Here we choose how each channel is configured. The board has up to four channels. We can go brushed motors or stepper motors, or disable the channels if we're not using them. We can configure the send rate, so this is how frequently updates are sent on the WebSocket back to the ESP32. We can hit the plus to add a widget to the page. These widgets we can move around, we can grab them by the corners and resize them. We can delete them, and each one of them has their own settings where we can change what type of widget it is. So far only joystick, tank or two-wheel joystick, which is a differential drive, or buttons work. We can choose which channels they use for each of the motors. Like a joystick has got steering backward and forward, differential drive has left and right, and buttons has got primary and a secondary motor. So if we're creating a tank, we might want to have one joystick and have 0A, 0B, or 1A, 1B, depending on where you have your motors connected. And probably if it's a touch device, just resize this to take up the whole screen. Hit the spanner again to exit configuration mode. And now we have a joystick here where we can control which direction we are moving in. To develop the web pages, I've used JS Fiddle and got all my code working here before I copied all this code to the ESP32. The code has been minified and formatted so that it's in C++ strings. So if we take a look at our HTML, it's all condensed and each of our quotes is being escaped so that it works as a C++ string. If you have any questions or problems, please leave a comment on the video. Or if you'd like to see more of this content, please subscribe.